Hello friend, welcome to Marine Engineering Hub. Today I am going to talk about cylinder liner veer. This is a part 2 video. Earlier I have made about corrosion veer. In cold corrosion and clover lipping was explained. In part 2 I am going to explain abrasion veer and adhesive veer. So let's begin the video. What is a abrasion and how it is caused? So basically, before knowing the abrasion, we should know that what is the catalytic fines, because catalytic fines are the main reason which causes abrasive wear inside the liner surface. So catalytic fines are the particles of silicon and aluminium oxide which are carried over during the cracking process in the refinery. So as we all know that the oil is refined in the refinery by using the fractional distillation method. Okay, and most of the impurities are removed during that process, but some impurities like silicon aluminium oxide cannot be removed permanently, so that causes abrasive wear if it is present in a large amount in filled particles. Now IMO has standardized a limit of 80 milligram per liter of catalytic fines are acceptable. If it is above, then we can also debunker the oil because it is not suitable for burning inside the marine diesel engine. Now one more thing I want to tell you, that catalytic fines can be removed or can be removed by a large extent by using a hot filter. Means at high temperature, using a hot filter, we can remove a large quantity of silicon aluminium oxide. Okay, and therefore you can see that in the fuel line filter, a hot filter, a filter with a steam coil coiled is provided in the fuel oil system. Okay, now how catalytic fine causes abrasive wear? Basically catalytic fine are like hard particles, okay, and that get between the liner and piston. This is liner suppose and this is piston. That hard particles basically of silicon aluminium type, it get in between the liner and piston, and as it move, this act as a miniature tool, cutting tool, and it cuts the liner surface, okay, and causes the wear. Okay, so see, same thing I have written here. This act like a miniature cutting tool, removing the metal from the ring and the liner. Other abrasive particle which causes the abrasive wear are the soot from the poor combustion and the ash from the cylinder oil, causing poor polishing. So apart from catalytic fines causing the abrasive wear, soot because of the poor combustion also may get in between the liner and piston and can cause abrasive wear, as well as will cause a bore polishing, resulting in the liner and piston contact and increasing the wear rate. Okay, now let's move to the second part, micro seizure. So basically what happened if the lubrication between the liner and piston, suppose this is liner, this is piston, if the lubrication in between the surface suppose is not there, in that case the two surface will rub against each other and a large amount of heat will be generated. Okay, and as you know, as they are moving around the speed of suppose 90 to 120 in slow speed engine, so and combustion space condition is already present there, so that amount of heat, what it causes, it causes the instantaneous stack welding. Means that because of localized heat generation, the heat is generated in such a large amount that instantaneous stack welding occurs between two surfaces. And as the piston is moving up and down, the surface will get tear off. And as it tear off, it causes catastrophic wear rate. Catastrophic wear of that part. Okay. So basically what happened? Cylinder wear rate increases drastically if there is no lubrication in between liner and piston. Excessive heat is generated due to lack of lubrication, which causes instantaneous stack welding, but due to the piston movement it gets shear off. As I have told you, this causes catastrophic wear known as micro seizure. So to prevent micro seizure, we first what we need to make ensure that a lubrication film is formed in between the piston and the liner surface, and that can be ensured by ensuring that the lubricating coils, which are provided all around the circumference of the liner, is injecting properly, which we can monitor or inspect during the scavenge inspection. As you can see in this diagram, a scoring type is formed. Scoring type mark are been present in the liner surface, indicating the micro seizure. Okay, so this is the micro seizure and this is the abrasion. So I hope you understand. Please do like and subscribe, and please share with your friend. I'm trying to make this video so that all of the marine related friends are benefited and can be bring to this platform to share your knowledge. Please do like and subscribe. Email credit goes to marinediesel.uk. thank you friend.